creating ideas, connecting people, building brands. Isn't that what it's all about? Richmond Corporate Video.
Even though he was one of the greatest poets of America. I'm talking about Walt Whitman, born in Long Island in 1819, spent most of his life in Brooklyn in poverty. But about him, it's been said that he's America's poet, that an English writer said, you cannot really understand America without Walt Whitman, without Leaves of Grass. And the critic Harold Bloom said, if you are American, then Walt Whitman is your imaginative father and mother, even if, like myself, you have never composed a line of verse. You can nominate a fair number of literary works as candidates for the secular scripture of the United States, but none of these is as central as the first edition of Leaves of Grass. So this is a poem called, O Me, O Life. O me, O life, of the questions of these recurring, of the endless trains of the faithless, of cities filled with the foolish, of myself forever reproaching myself, for who more foolish than I, and who more faithless? Of eyes that vainly crave the light, of the objects mean, of the poor results of all, of the plodding and sordid crowds I see around me, of the empty and useless years of the rest, with the rest, me intertwined. Oh me, the question so sad recurring, what good amid these, O me, O life? Answer, that you are here, that life exists and identity, that the powerful play goes on, and that you may contribute a verse, that the powerful play goes on, and that you may contribute a verse.
Okay, now I'd like to introduce our speaker today, Nate Marcus, the founder and CEO of OccasionGenius. You'll notice when he gets up here, he's pretty young, but like Encorepreneurs, he's done a lot in a short period of time. He's taught Spanish in a Catholic boarding school. He's taken youths on trips to Latin America, Europe, and Asia. He was an instructor in a cooking school. He's worked in a couple of early stage businesses, and now he's founded what was PartyRVA when it got started. It's an award-winning young entrepreneurial company, and I think he'll have an exciting message for you today. Nate?
Well, hi, everybody. Thank you. Low expectations are the secret to happiness. Let's just remember that as we do everything, including listening to this presentation. No, I was joking that I was hoping we'd have technical difficulty. So we don't, and onward, here we go. This is a very different presentation than the one I usually give, because I think this is an opportunity to talk less about my journey and OccasionGenius, and more about the incredible opportunities that I've discovered that are here in Richmond. So my goal is that by the end of this, you'll have discovered at least 10 things that you never knew existed that you can go out and do here in Richmond. So before this, I was teaching Iron Chef team building classes at Mise en Place Cooking School. How many people have been to Mise en Place Cooking School? So that's the problem. Richmond is full of hidden gems, things that you never knew were out there. And I would teach for groups of 16 to 60, groups from Altria, Capital One, Dominion, Genworth, and I'd give them mystery ingredients. 1 hour, no recipes, no smartphones, go. So if you see them Chopped or Iron Chef, just like that, I'd yell at them, 5 minutes, chefs, hands off. And I'd rate them on taste, creativity, and presentation. Bragging rights, trash talking. They loved it. And every time they said, this is so much fun, this must be new. I'd say, that's funny that you think that. The school's been here for 11 years, 13 now. They say, that's not possible. See, it's just not possible because we have all this money to do team outings. Every quarter rolls over to the next quarter. We're always looking for fun things to do, and we always end up going bowling. And we can't go bowling anymore. So I'd hear this over and over for about a year and a half and thinking, come on, you've got it. So I did some focus groups. And I said, what's going on? You have an internal list of fun things to do in Richmond at your company, don't you? And say, heck no, we don't have anything like that. We wish that there were some website where we could go and find things to do, where we could organize it by group size and zip code and price and availability. And they said, but you know what's even harder than finding ideas? What's even worse is getting group buy-in. So raise your hand if you've had the experience of a never-ending email chain. A lot more than people who have been to Mise en Place Cooking School. What about the violent agreement in a room? Or the passive aggressivism, or the feeling of forced fun. So there's a lot of friction when it comes into figuring out what to do as a group. And in fact, if you are voluntold to plan one, you're either out of luck or you're a masochist, because there is nothing more harrowing than trying to get a group of people to do something together for fun. So they said, well, we wish there were a site where we could create a limited list of pre-approved awesome ideas and send it to everybody for a group vote, and the thing with the most votes would win. So I said, sure, we'll do that. Created PartyRVA, launched it in 2015, and very quickly it grew, won multiple awards. We got into Lighthouse Labs Accelerator. 77,000 people in Richmond came onto our site and booked private events, corporate and milestone. And I started to recognize how difficult it is. It's not so much the problem, it's not so much that there's nothing fun to do in Richmond. It's a marketing problem. The problem is that there's no place for people to go to find these ideas, and previously there was no place for these companies in Richmond to go to let people planning private events know that they could plan them. So what I want to do now is share with you some of the things that we discovered. I've taken this and divided it into 10 themes of new activities that you can find in Richmond that you could not have found, let's say, 5 or even 4 or 3 years ago. So how many people here have been to an escape room? Oh, okay. So if you haven't noticed, this is the national craze. Richmond now has 8 escape room companies offering a total of 24 different escape rooms that you can try to escape from. This is the brand new one. It's called Breakout. They opened 2 months ago. They actually will put you in handcuffs. For those of you who don't know, an escape room is a room where you're trapped. Well, not really, because in the state of Virginia, that's called kidnapping. You can talk to Gary over here if you need help about that. So you're trapped in a room, and you have to solve clues or puzzles for 60 minutes to get out. Real Escape Room Richmond now traps you with a live actor in zombie makeup who has a, and Walking Dead fans in here, who has a chain that releases every 5 minutes, will release 5 more inches until at the end of the hour there's no place to escape from the zombie. There's MI6, you can play Battleship with your friends. There's just such a multitude of different experiences, and they rotate all the time. We actually have in Richmond a mobile escape room, so to speak, that's been here for over 10 years, Raven Chase Adventures. And they've been creating basically escape room type scavenger hunts, and they'll come to you. And I think that the future of escape rooms is going to be mobile, where they're going to just come to your office, come to your house, come to your kids' party location. Now, if you like to shoot things in Richmond, there is no shortage of different things that you can shoot. So if you're familiar with the Hunger Games, this started a national craze for archery tag. If you think archery tag sounds bloody, keep in mind that at the end of each arrow is a marshmallow foam type tip that does not sting, though you do wear goggles. We now have two companies in Richmond offering archery tag, one that will come to any location, and one that's at G-Force Carts. So raise it, who's been to G-Force? They've been a staple return, a lot of people. Now G-Force has gotten on top of this trend of experiences, recognizing that millennials especially value experiences over things, and they've been creating more and more. So they just redid their laser tag. It's a two-story arena that's now, used to be jungle themed, now it's apocalypse themed. They have Z-Ball paintball. It's paintless paintball, it shoots foam. And as of 6 weeks ago, introduced Nerf gun battles. So they have now 16 different Nerf guns that you can battle your friends and family and team for about 30 minutes. If you want to shoot something a little heavier, then we now have three shooting galleries. Colonial Shooting Academy was the other only one we had. In October, Blue Ridge Arsenal opened up across from Bass Pro, where you can shoot basically any gun. They actually have a, this isn't working anymore. There we go. Well, we've got into that pod and we've gone into the future. There we go. They actually have something called Shoot Any Gun, where you can shoot any gun that they have there. There is this category that I'm just going to call RVA Disney, because it feels like almost any ride at Disney World you can now get to do while you're here in Richmond. G-Force, of course, has been offering go-karts, which I kind of think of like the Disney bumper carts. Thunderbolt Indoor Karting came on the scene about 2.5 years ago. They have all electric carts in a new facility. Their carts were designed by Ferrari, so you can get some really incredible speed there. We have Sky Zone, a national brand, of course, of a trampoline park. Our local version is Jumpology, and they have since added a ninja obstacle warrior course. So you can feel like a ninja warrior on TV. We have a curling club in Richmond. Has anybody seen this Olympic sport? It's an Olympic sport. Has anybody played this Olympic sport? So in about 2.5 hours, you can come beers on the ice and you can learn how to play, learn what it is, learn how to play, get some practice, and actually play a game with you and your company and your friends. For warmer weather, I think we know, you know, outside is called Richmond, the River City for so many times. We've got a lot of great river activities, from stand-up paddleboard. One of my favorites of recent years is the lazy river tubing. This does not take you on the rapids. They will give you a cooler that will float in the river with you. You cannot drink alcohol on the river, but you can drink just about anything else. Buck, I'm so glad that Buck is here, because Buck is, I would say, one of these quintessential entrepreneurs who understands the value of experiences over things and has been bringing them to Richmond. He's also taken Segway tours and made them quintessentially Richmond. So you've got Hollywood Cemetery tours, you have Black History tours, and you have art mural tours, so you can explore Richmond in a really new and different way. And then when you think of Disney, you think of characters. Teeny Tiny Farm will bring a mobile petting zoo to your house. They only need a little bit of outdoor space, and they will bring llamas, they will bring miniature cows, it's so cute. They'll bring bunnies and baby ducks. The next one, it's a really interesting trend that we're seeing nationwide. Less young people are going to golf courses to play golf. And so golf courses have had to reinvent themselves in order to think about how to market this large area to a younger demographic. The fastest growing sport in America is currently foot golf. We now have two golf courses Independence and Windy Hill that have drilled soccer ball-sized holes at the end of every hole. So Stan, you can play golf and I can play foot golf, and anybody else who wants to can play, as of April, a brand new sport in Richmond, fling golf. This is a cross between lacrosse and golf. You can find it at Hunting Hawk. And you fling the ball over your shoulder. So now all three generations can play the same hole at the same time. Now you've probably heard about hot yoga or Bikram yoga. This was a big craze, I'd say about 10 years ago. What you might not have heard about is acro yoga, circus yoga, or hammock yoga. Fighting Gravity Fitness for at least 3 years has been offering yoga from hammocks that are on hung up from the top. And Shaco Yoga downtown is offering glow in the dark yoga. They'll even give you body paint for right before. Number six is bubbles. I don't know what it is about Richmond and bubbles, but we seem to have a preponderance of ways to celebrate with a group in a bubble. Richmond Bubble Soccer came about a month before I created PartyRVA, and I said, wow, who knows about this? It was a perfect match. This is where you get into a bubble, and a lot of people forget that there is actually a soccer game going on because they're just bouncing off of one another. Bosses, beware. This is actually an excuse for your employees. We call it a vengeance party. An excuse for them to bounce about you. So Richmond Bubble Soccer next month is offering LED lights inside their bubbles so you can play at night. Going the wrong way. And Game Truck has now offered bubble soccer for a few months, and they bring this inflatable arena around you so that the ball can't escape. Again, bosses, look out, you can't escape. Now this is different. This is a Zorb ball. This is just tiny bit north. The only company I had to include it though, they're just a tiny bit north of Richmond. This is called Bubble Adventures. Here's the deal. You put your friend in the bubble, you push your once friend down the hill, and you try to knock over the inflatable bowling pins. This is a real thing. And this is one of my favorite local companies. This is RVA Bubbles. It's a mother-daughter combo. The daughter at 13 years old said she was interested in a business, so the mom said, let's create one together, and the daughter wanted to create Bubbles RVA, a way to get people blowing bubbles. They created their own detergent mix. They created their own wands. And now they will show you how to blow bubbles the size of a car. This is actually probably the size of a bus. Gaming is taking on a really interesting spin. If people are familiar with Game Truck, they're in Richmond. So are five others, so six total, local Game Truck options, from Game Patrol to Galaxy Gamer. So what is this? This is basically they will bring a gaming parlor to your house or to your office. And a lot of adults are using them to have tailgate parties. The walls come out and you can show the game in your backyard. Who here has gotten the chance to do VR? Raise your hand. That's actually a lot of people. Okay, this looks silly, downright silly when you're seeing it on social media or somebody doing it, but I had a chance, I get to sample the goods. It's a worst part of my job. So gotta try this at KLG Games. Brand new, you might have seen it in Business Sense a few weeks ago. Just opened up in downtown. They are creating a basement where they'll have about 16 VR headsets. I have to tell you, it is the coolest thing. I totally get why Facebook is investing so much money in it. It is mind-blowing. So the next opportunity that you have to try it, just jump on in, put that headset on and give it a shot. And we're seeing more companies start to come about now that are bringing VR to you. If you don't want to learn anything new, then you're out of luck, because wherever you look, there's opportunities to try something out, and it's really an experience. So Comedy Zone Sports has been doing this, and they've recently offered improv classes and improv training. So in a day, you can learn how to say yes to just about anything. And one very interesting thing we're seeing a lot of is divorce parties, by the way. So, all right, we'll go there. So there's two types of divorce parties that we see that people are booking through our site. One is the bachelorette type, where you're celebrating your newfound singledom. The other is where both parts of the couple will invite all of their friends and family, thank them for the great memories, and ask them to support them as they move on. You can imagine which one's more popular. We just had a destroy the knot request come through our site last week. So these are tassels. You can make tassels and learn burlesque. We've got places like Boom Boom Basics and other places for guys. There are something called tasticles, which you can try on. Somebody had to donate some underwear for that photo shoot. We'll move on for that. Flynn at Soul Aerial performing Circus and Performing Arts is another one of these amazing Richmonder entrepreneurs who are just creating a whirlwind of experiences, from burlesque parties to belly dancing, from chair dancing and pole dancing to, yes, twerking. We now have twerking parties in Richmond. I will demo that maybe after the break. Now, everybody knows Richmond is a great place for foodie, for food. But what's new now is that we've started to create experiences around eating the amazing food in Richmond. So we now have two food tour companies. This is like Eat, Walk, Repeat. This is Maureen Egan of Real Richmond Food Tours. Brian has created a new one that does a lot of Carytown Suite Tours. And they'll create customized food tours and public food tours for you to go meet the chefs, meet the owners, and try food. We now have other ways to try this than just walking. So Richmond Rides, owned by Catherine Illion, has created four bike tours, one of which is a foodie tour where you actually go every time you stop, try some food and meet the local owners. Ann Porch has just created Basket and Bike about 2 or 3 months ago. This takes advantage of our new Capitol Trail and starts and ends at the Shirley Winery for some wine tasting and picnic basket foods. And Buck has now just brought, I'm so excited to start to get the word out, Pedego Electric Bikes. It's Richmond's first electric bike rental. Show of hands, who's tried an electric bike? Awesome. Okay, so now we have the opportunity to do rentals. They'll give you everything you need to have an awesome excursion. They have a barbecue bike rental excursion where you can get some barbecue and come back. And thanks to Buck as well, we now have trolley tours. Their craft beer tour in a trolley is one of their most popular and is a way for people to experience all of the new craft breweries that we have in town. We also have wine tasting, wine pairing events, wine tours, winery tours. These are by Terracina St. Clair of the Tipsy Sommelier. All right, and lastly, a huge trend has been making things. How many people, show of hands, has done paint night? Yeah, a lot of people. We have about 7 different paint night companies, from Paint and Play RVA to Wine and Design, Spirited Art, Paint Night. What you might not know about, which is now new, is now we have Plant Night. This is the same thing. You have a buzz, you make something, but instead of making paintings, you create a terrarium. So this is our group making terrariums to take home. And Happy Trees Entertainment has come to Richmond. They are bringing in Beads and Bubbly. So this launched just last month. This is where you actually create necklaces and jewelry to then be able to gift or take home. We have cork crafting and more cork crafting. There we go. Pottery making. There's just a resurgence of opportunities. You can make your own t-shirts. There of ways to have a social experience, make something, and be able to take that thing home. So if you've been reading the newspaper or BizSense, you'll see that this is not stopping. We are in the age of experiences. So if you've heard of Topgolf, that's likely coming to Richmond at some point. Yeah, they're all about having an experience. Where there's a bar that's looking to open up that has like a bari, I think they're gonna call it. It's like Atari meets a bar. So you can drink and play video games. We have a very upscale bowling alley trying to make its way into Scott's Addition. We're seeing more and more of these innovative Richmond entrepreneurs doing this. And that, I would say, is really the theme that I've noticed, is that these are not companies primarily coming from outside of Richmond. These are local Richmond entrepreneurs who are creating experiences that are uniquely Richmond, that they are really at the forefront of what it means to have a really interesting hosted experience with a group. And we believe at Occasion Genius that that makes life better, that group shared experiences make life better. So the way that our site works, it's completely free to use. And our mission is to support the local entrepreneurs that are making these great experiences happen by getting the word out about them. We just are capping off our second raise. We're over 70% committed. Any accredited investors in the audience, I would love to talk to you. Come say hi. We're really proud of the fact that we are a Richmond company helping, especially Richmond businesses, and so far all of our investors are local Richmonders. I think I'm at time. Please. Get out and try some of these experiences that are in Richmond. If you haven't done an escape room, if you haven't done a food tour, there are so many activities that are great for all ages, all fitness levels. It's a really incredible trend that we're riding, and I hope you take advantage of it. Thank you guys so much for having me.